Welcome to the D-pad. My name is John.
My name is Rick.
So, John, what are you doing today?
What are you?
Well,
doing today,
I'm fighting bug catcher Brent. I have a friend named Brent.
If we had a Jamie and Adam dynamic for this episode, do you think it would work?
Nope. Denied.
Welcome to D-Busters.
Oh, jeez. Rock is strong against bug, right?
You ever say something, and as you say it, you realize what you're actually saying?
Oh, wait. Shouldn't have said that.
Yeah. No, not shouldn't have said it, but just like the name D-Buster is just kind of...
Gah.
Yeah.
Rock throw.
I feel like Jamie Heineman's voice is the voice of someone who's been D-Busted.
D-Busted.
I was D-Busted earlier this morning.
I have nothing to say to you. I can't handle it. It's all these bee drills I keep squishing under rocks.
You gotta bust them bees.
Bloop. Bloop.
Hit two times.
Hit two times, maybe? Doesn't look like I was hit two times, you know what I'm saying?
My brain is all over my brain just went like, hey, it'll be really cool right now. Go to like a Dave & Buster's or something.
Look at my experience. Like, literally, I'm 1 point away.
See, even the trainer's like, what?
Yeah.
You didn't level up?
What a total waste of time. I totally agree. Thanks, bug catcher Brent. You're a real friend.
Oh, God.
All right, so I can catch something here, right?
Yes, you can. You actually got to go with the grass.
I got to, like, think about it for a second.
If you want to catch anything.
Ba-da-ba. I forget. Do I have full swipe on anybody? No, but you're pretty weak.
I had no idea.
So that's good. I think I got rid of it for cut.
It's entirely possible.
Oh my God, what's it gonna be?
Nope.
Bro.
Nope, it's not.
Nope.
Shut it down.
You already got that.
Bye. What do you mean can't escape? Don't give me that. You're not a person. You're not arena trapping me. Don't even.
Wow.
What's it?
You're doing good.
Be?
You're doing
what's
good.
What's it
though?
Gonna? Nope.
Re-a-tata.
I already have Ratatatatata, and he's as much as I need. Goodbye. What? Do you just suck at running away? What is wrong with you? What?
Just. Oh, my God,
at this
man.
Point, I'm going to run away out of principle. Yeah, that's right. Got away safely, mofo.
You know what? You can't actually catch anything here.
Oh, did you already write that down?
You can only catch Rattata, Spearow, and Sandshrew. So you can't even surf or fish here. This one's empty.
What about... Sandshrew.
You have Sandshrew.
No, I don't.
You had a Sandshrew.
Why you gotta be like that, Rick?
Because you cried. And I derive pleasure from your tears.
Why did I leave fucking Farfetch'd out front?
Ugh! You're fighting bug Pokemon. You're fine.
Well, I guess so. Like level
Connor,
40
Connor! That's not how you spell Connor.
No, it's not. Interesting observation.
Who? Chudding.
Oh my God!
Oh my God, you eviscerated my Caterpie!
He's just like a pile. Ding!
You're a pile.
Oh my God, it's Weedle. I can do this.
Do it, do it. You can do it. Do it. Just do it. You can do it. Oof. God, that looks ferocious.
Nice.
Yeah!
Venonat. No, I seem to be doing okay with this whole thing, so I'm gonna aerial ace you in the face, you. Oh,
so
Venonat, a little chunkier.
This will make for a good conversation right now. We'll talk about it more for.
I doubt it.
During the Ocarina episode that goes up, but
yeah.
The rumor going around right now, new Nintendo 3DS is probably coming out on February 13th.
Uh-huh.
Majora's Mask 3D may also be coming out alongside it on the 13th of February.
Which
puts us in a really complicated position.
Right. Because we were like, you know, we've got a lot of time to kill before Majora's Mask 3DS comes out, so let's play Ocarina of Time 3DS.
Right? They said earlier that it was going to come out in spring 2015, which February,
well,
for one, is not spring. That's winter.
Optimistic.
And two... The actual 15th anniversary of Majora's Mask would have fallen in April, and that seems like the best time to release the game, like right on the anniversary.
I'm gonna do it, you guys.
And oh
gonna
no,
do it.
You're not.
It's Gonna be fine.
He has shitty defense. That's what it is.
Yeah, I know. I saw the comment too. But
are you gonna? Are you act? God be with you. Okay.
Nice.
I was just like, ooh, yeah. But yeah, so I figured it would come out around April. That seemed like the logical point for it.
Yeah.
And spring, honestly, let's be real. When Nintendo gives out an estimate for a release date, it's usually the later end of whenever it's estimating.
Yeah, always.
So we were sort of like, oh, it'll be fine. It'll come out in April. We'll have plenty of time to do this. If it comes out in February, we're fucked. We're like really in a shitty spot. We had three options. Meg came in here to give John a little smooch. And
kiss
then leaned in on my mic,
as if to do the same for Rick.
She did not give me one. I'm just gonna put that out there.
Sorry, buddy.
Feel left out.
Better luck next time.
Is that okay? But yeah, so like we had three options ultimately. One was we just cut off the Ocarina Let's Play altogether and just dump it in favor of Majora, which is shitty. I don't like doing that.
Yeah, that's lame.
We built up all this stuff for a Majora's Mask thing. I don't want to just end it.
Right. So the other options.
Another option was we play through Ocarina as normal and just do Majora's Mask when that comes out. Mm-hmm. Also a shitty option. That one only really works if, like, there was a desperate need to have the new Nintendo 3DS capture card for, like, the whole game for Majora's Mask.
Yep.
If that is the case, like, if it's an entirely different experience, maybe. Another one was it was a mild compromise that I came up with that we ultimately decided against was... what if we just... So Master Quest is only different for the dungeons. What if we only did dungeon episodes?
Which is a cool idea, but then we still have to play the whole damn game anyway.
Exactly.
So we
like
might
we're
as
playing
well
a lot, and it's not going to be quite the same. So rather than doing that, we're just like, you know what? Majora's Mask, when it comes out, we'll just start playing it.
Yeah, and we'll could take a break from Ocarina if we had to, but like we'd just play them both.
Yeah.
So you know what I realize? My head's in like a super weird.
Yeah, you're like in this.
Position.
You got this like Stephen Hawking pose going on with your neck.
Because the microphone just was like, nope. Don't you dare.
Don't you dare Patreon me.
Yeah, nice try. Picnicker Caitlin. That meow.
Hey there, Caitlin.
Cha-ding. Sure, I can just. You probably can't hurt me. Oh God.
Oh.
It's really strong for some reason. Not quite enough. yes.
Oh, they're going to steal your mons.
Yeah, but I'm going to steal his life.
There he goes. Like, I hope it gets him.
Your money or your life. Yep, I win.
Boast.
I may heal today.
I really hope that they do, like, a mega Farfetch'd or something. He's always been, like...
He's just wielding a tree.
He's just been such a quirky Pokemon that it's sad that he doesn't get so much love anymore.
Yeah, he's cool, though.
I've always loved Farfetch'd. Onion Knight was arguably the most depressing loss for me.
Wow.
Because it
that
came,
is sad.
In X, because it came... I was so demoralized by losing everybody else.
Yep.
That losing him was just kind of like... If my trainer was a person, I wouldn't fault him for walking off a cliff shortly after.
So this is Route 10. Can
it
I get something here?
Try.
Oh, no. Oh, okay. I was like,
No, it's gone now. That's it. You don't get to choose anything. Voltorb.
Wait, I caught one, didn't I?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I really thought I caught one.
Nope.
I really don't want a Voltorb.
Too bad.
Damn.
As it turns out, by the way, in Ruby Sapphire, that little glowing yellow ball that we saw in the grass was not a Plusle or Mine, and it was actually a Voltorb.
That doesn't super surprise me.
Yeah.
Electrode is also really fast, so I guess that could be cool if I had like Dugtrio and Electrode, like really fast dudes. Oh my God, is he gonna self-destruct?
That's probably gonna use like Discharge or something.
How often do they self-destruct in the wild? Here, I'm just gonna do this.
I don't know. You're resistant to normal type attacks though, so even if he even if he did, I mean, granted,
at this point,
at half health when you're paralyzed.
Yeah,
it's not
half health, paralyzed, unintelligent, smarmy. Yeah. Wild Voltorb, use Sonic Boom again. Why does it do so much?
I don't know.
Fine.
I'd focus on unparalyzing him.
That's a little better.
Go to sleep, mechanical monster.
Yeah, what? What is a Voltorb? Like, it begs the question, like, have Pokemon balls always existed? And did Voltorbs...
To reproduce, probably, yeah.
Did Voltorbs evolve as a reaction to, why can't I handle my life? Just give me a fucking Pokeball. Oh my god, I'm so out of it right now. Pokeball. You know what I mean, though? Like,
you put a Voltorb in a smaller Voltorb.
The only way Voltorb makes sense is if that Pokeballs have existed since the dawn of time and Voltorbs evolved naturally. And I'm not talking about Pokemon evolution. I'm talking about Darwinian evolution over time to blend in with them.
Big question is, I mean, that's not entirely true.
Yes.
I mean, it's there are aspects of it that could work. I mean, there are creatures that evolve over time as response to other creatures, like hot peppers. Hot peppers have evolved their spiciness as a defense mechanism.
Yeah.
Because they're so rich in vitamin C. Not even humans, birds. Birds are all over that stuff.
Bratlov.
Bratlov? Really?
It just made sense.
Jesus Christ.
In my brain at this moment.
You know, okay. That's only going to make sense if you get him to Electrode. Voltorb has evolved into Bratlov.
Yeah. What? I'll rename him Electrode.
It'd be Edort Kelly.
Yeah, exactly.
Edort Seal.
That's what
that's like a Dorp Snafu.
That is just like a Dorp Snafu. Oh my god, you can't run indoors. It's me, one of the ever-present aides of Professor Oak. 20 species, give me your reward. What do you got?
It's a call forward. Don't worry about it, guys. Yeah. You've
only caught 19. Fuck you, dude.
Oh! You don't want the Everstone out anyway.
Lavender Town. That's true. Do I want to switch in Voltorb? He could actually be kind of interesting.
Not in the rock tunnel. Or against a grass gym.
Okay, valid point. But I got...
You do not have a good team for this gym coming up,
normal
man.
Flying.
Chiding is
fighting,
your best chance right now.
Grass poison.
Chiding
ground,
and Angry Birds.
And Psychic.
You could get bait leveled up, then you'd have a bug and flying.
No, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
You got Harvey.
It's not going to work. Harvey right. Birdman? No.
They going to challenge you?
Probably.
Oh!
I've been out of Pokemon gym. It's weird that they have like the cut trees there.
Yeah, I don't get that.
As an option for not having to fight this person.
Yeah, that seems needless.
Pikachu, you know who I'm going to switch out? Chiding.
Maybe Chiding. Get rid of Chiding.
Oh, nope, that's not a bag, though. Yeah.
Jesus, who still has not gained a single level.
Yeah, because look at him. He's beastly.
Looks like three balls.
Oh.
He looks like a pile of discarded testicles.
I like that you added that they were discarded.
Well,
like,
they're not
good
anymore. Is
it like
one and a half dudes underground? Just like, no, just stick it up there. Come on, go.
Pew! Oh, he's dead. Look at that. Look at that.
Yikes.
Okay. Chiding gained a boost to 262. Jesus gained 175. Clefairy. No, I'm going to murder a Clefairy. Now that you said he hasn't gained a level, I'd like to have him gain a level.
He won't.
I know. What does this do? Why is there a disembodied hand waggling at me?
She became the center of attention.
Well, that's good. I am pretty much focused on you right now.
Okay, well, that was easy. After all my training in which I told you I lost. All right, so I guess next time we're going to go to Rock Tunnel.
Oh my god, I'm so scared.